Hey everyone, welcome to week 10 of Tuesday Tips. This is going to be the last beginner week. Next week I'll be putting out a couple of walkthrough solves on 5, 6, and 7 that are kind of only using what I'd say beginner techniques to be, so you can kind of follow along and make sure you're kind of not missing anything out as you practice. So week 10 is going to be about look ahead when you're solving your centers. So a lot of people In general, a lot of people tend to kind of turn as fast as they can when they're doing big cubes in general. They want to they do they see what they see what they can see. They plan out their moves. They do those moves, and then they look for the next moves, and then they do those. The obvious problem in this kind of method of solving is that you're stopping every so often to kind of pick your next moves. Oops. You're stopping every so often to pick your next move. So, as an example, if I see, let's see, what do I see? Okay, I've planned, I see blue and white, blue and white, blue and white. And now I know the moves, so I'll just do them, and I won't look for anything else. And I solved the blue and white edge. And now I'm clueless again. I have no idea what's going on. I have to look, I have to just pause again and look around. Oh, I see red and white. And I'll do the moves. Maybe I'll do them really fast because I know what the moves are and I can do them really fast. I take red and white out, and now I'm stuck again. However, it's much more efficient to always be looking for things as you're going. You don't want to ever be pausing on your edges. The goal of edges is to be as fluid as possible. If you're ever pausing during your edges for whatever reason, you're doing something wrong. Usually, that something wrong is the fact that you're turning too fast. As you can see there, that was a little slower than I kind of my maximum speed during a solve, but I didn't pause once during the remainder of those first 8 edges. This is because I turned to the speed, well, in this case, I turned to a slightly lower speed than I knew I'd be able to handle. The speed I'd be able to handle, meaning that you can still track your pieces while you're turning. If you're turning really fast, the colors are moving way too quickly for you to be able to see. You're not going to be able to kind of where everything is. Your brain's not going to be able to process where the pieces go and what kind of is available next. Obviously, this kind of cap in ability is heavily dependent on how comfortable you are, how experienced you are, as I can just take a quick glance at the top of the cube and I can see a lot more than someone who's only been cubing for a year or so, and I can see a lot more than I saw just a year or a few months ago just because of practice. I know what to look for and kind of just in general experience, obviously. So it's really kind of edges are about finding the maximum speed that you're able to still track pieces in, and you kind of want to get as close to that as possible without pushing it over. So if you're solving edges and you notice you literally never pause once ever, especially while you're practicing, you're probably turning a little too slow. Because theoretically, everyone can go as slow as possible and never make a single pause during their edges, because it's very easy to track pieces when you're only moving at a snail's pace. However, if you're going really fast, like I used to do a lot during my solves, and you have a lot of breaks, oops. What did I do? If you're going really fast on your edges and you have a lot of breaks, this is going to be a large problem for you, as it's going to add overall time to your solves that you could have easily saved off by kind of planning ahead while doing your other moves. I'd recommend while you're practicing, kind of, if you notice you're pausing a lot during edges, definitely do some slow turning solves. Maybe even turn slow enough to where you finally get to the point where you actually do not pause at all during your solves. So you kind of know of what a baseline, what it feels like to have completely fluid edges, and then kind of maybe pick up the TPS from there ever so slowly until maybe you're pausing just once or twice during your solves when kind of things get a little out of hand. But you're certainly able to control what you're doing at all times, and you kind of know, and it's very easy to plan your next steps. Yeah, as you get more experienced, obviously the speed at which you can turn to keep fluid edges will increase, and that's kind of just part of getting faster. So, yeah, that's kind of a general overview of how to practice edges and kind of what you should be shooting for. You should be shooting for completely fluid edges with the maximum speed, but obviously that's going to be pretty difficult. So yeah, stay tuned for some walkthrough solves next week.